Ah, Miss Kenton. Mr. Cardinal has just arrived, out of the blue. He'll be expecting his usual room tonight.
I shall see to it before I leave.
Oh, you're going out this evening?
I am indeed. It's Thursday.
Of course. I'd forgotten. Sorry.
Is something the matter?
No, no. Some visitors are expected to arrive, but it doesn't involve you, really.
We agreed that Thursday is my day off. But, of course, if you should need me urgently, it's...
No, it's perfectly all right. Thank you. Thank you.
Mr. Stevens.
Yes?
I have something to tell you. My friend, the man I'm going to meet tonight, you know him, Mr. Benn.
Oh, yes, Mr. Benn, of course, yes.
He has asked me to marry him. I am thinking about it.
I see.
He's moving back to the West Country next month.
Hmm.
I'm still thinking about it. I thought you should be informed of the situation.
Yes, sir, thank you. That is most kind of you, Miss Kenton. Well, I trust you'll have a most pleasant evening, Miss Kenton. Thank you.
Of course, miss. Sorry to have alarmed you. Just security, miss.
Thank you.
I trust you had a pleasant evening. Love, did you have a pleasant evening?
Yes, thank you.
Good.
Would you like to know what took place?
I have to return upstairs. There are events of the utmost importance taking place in this house tonight.
When are there not? I accepted his proposal.
Miss Kenton?
I accepted Mr. Benn's proposal of marriage.
My congratulations.
I am prepared to serve out my notice, but if you were able to release me earlier, I would be grateful. Mr. Benn is planning to leave for the West Country in 2 weeks' time.
I'll do my best. Now, please excuse me.
Mr. Stevens?
Yes.
Am I to take it that after all the years I have been in this house, you have nothing else to say to me?
You have my warmest congratulations.
Did you know you have been a very important figure for Mr. Benn and me?
Oh, in what way?
I tell him all sorts of things about you. I tell him stories about you, about your habits, about your mannerisms. He finds it very funny, especially when I show him how you pinch your nose when you put pepper on your food. That always has us in stitches.
Doesn't indeed. Well, please excuse me, Miss Kenton.
Yes, Mrs. Stevens.
Miss Kenton, I've been wanting to tell you. It's the smaller, alcove outside the breakfast room. It's the new girl, of course. But I find it has not been dusted in some time.
I'll see to it, Mr. Stevens.
Thank you. I knew you would have wanted to be informed, Miss Kenton. Excellent references. She was a matron at a boys' preparatory school in Sussex.
A matron, huh?
Yes, sir.
Huh. Well, it sounds like she'll know how to keep us from misbehaving, huh?
Oh, I certainly hope so, sir.
Good, Stephen. Very good. Now, this is where we had that banquet back in 35, remember? We all stood up and delivered ourselves of our principles. God knows what I said. Sure got worked up about it, though. What did I say anyway, Stephen?
I'm sorry, sir. I was too busy serving to listen to the speeches.
We got a visitor here.
You have to be very careful.
Come on.
Easy. Okay, easy.
Come on. It's just we are quiet, sir. If you don't want to start it. Can you come down?
I think if we leave the window.
Come on.
Good. Very still.
Go on.
Yes.
Go on. Out. Come on. Out.
Well done.
Well done, sir.